Hello, folks. Tim Walking Bear, the Plant Whisperer here. How y'all doing today? It's 5:18 in the morning, and I just got up. Living out here in the middle of the woods, off the grid. Somehow my door got blown open last night while I was sleeping, and I woke up to it being cold, and I had to fire up the wood stove. It's been really cold the past couple of nights. It's been down to below zero, but last night itself was pretty warm. Stayed in the 20s. Anyway, I just wanted to say a little something about community. I don't know if you guys can see me in the dark here. Probably not. So I'll just film the fire while I talk. But, you know, a lot of people these days are being drawn to form like-minded communities. You see it in the hippie culture. You see it in New Age movement. You see it in the Patriot movement. People are wanting to come together to form community out of like-mindedness. And that's all great and good. But quite frankly, it's not sustainable. There is no sustainable community throughout the history of human race across the globe that we see that is sustainable based upon commonality of social and life trends, such as New Age movements, religions, cultural beliefs. These are all common glues that help hold people together in union, but it is not what will sustain a community. You cannot base a community upon these things. And if you do base a community upon these things, then you're not really forming a community, you're forming a cult. A cult is a bunch of like-minded people coming together to form a community to live based upon like-mindedness. Well, that's a workable concept, but I don't think that's where we need to go today. If you want sustainable community in this changing world, it has to be much more basic and simple. The need to be sustainable together in a community setting has to be based on something that's more fundamental, like survival. When we look at indigenous societies around the globe throughout history, they are sustainable. The Maori are still together, the Lakota are still together, Mi'kmaq are still together. These people have had sustainable community for thousands of years. And it isn't because they base their community upon their cultural, spiritual beliefs or anything like that. Or because they all like the color blue or they all like moose or whatever. They're not doing it on a commonality-based system like that. They're doing it based on survival. Looking out for each other to survive. Looking at your surroundings, your environment, and learning to utilize those resources in a sustainable way for the people that you live with. That's community. That's real community. And that can't be ego-based. And there can be no ownership for it to work. If one person owns the land or one person owns the house where the so-called community is taking place, the one person ownership thing is going to come out and screw it up sooner or later. Because sooner or later, somebody's not going to agree with somebody and you're going to hear somebody say, "This is my house, this is my land, and you'll do things my way." They may not say it, but that's what will come out. Because we are humans and we are control freaks. The community that is sustainable has to be based upon a selfless mindset. And that takes conscious effort in today's world. Not everybody is capable of doing that. So anybody that's going to lead a community like that has to be able to separate from self and ego and make decisions and judgments based upon the well-being of the community and the environment that the community lives in. And you cannot look at that as an ownership. You have to look at it as it is there for the well-being of the whole group. Not one person is more entitled than another. Not one person has more to offer the community than another. Even though it may appear that way, every single human being within that community has something to offer and must be appreciated and utilized without ego. Hard to eliminate that. Hard to deal with that. But when you open the door to community based on cultish ideas of religion and social interaction, social customs, then you even open the door more for the ego, for the human ego. The control monster within people will come out and it will fail and people will get hurt. So if you're thinking of forming community, strip it down, make it basic. You are surviving. That's what you're doing. That's the glue that holds your community together. And quite frankly, when you look at the weather changes and the pattern changes of this whole solar system we're in, there's big changes taking place. And then you look at the human political world, big changes taking place. Quite frankly, I think we're out of time for creating cultish, social trend community type things. That could have been done 50 years ago and might have become sustainable today. But we didn't do it 50 years ago. So now we're down to the wire, and now it's more simple, much more simple. It's about survival. More time that goes by, the closer we get to an apocalyptic type scenario. It's unfolding right before us. The revelations in the Bible, the prophecies of the Hopi, prophecy of the Maori, prophecies of the Druids, all across the globe, these prophecies are unfolding before our very eyes. There's something big happening in our galaxy, in our solar system, and on our planet. Everybody thinks it's just global warming or weather change. Well, yes, that's a part of it, but that's just a manifestation of a deeper core, a deeper root. And the deeper root is shit's changing quick. All the countries that are mentioned in Revelations that line up around Israel, they're already in place. They're all there. You got some scary crap going on in the world. So it's not about coming together to make a community of like-minded people that can have a good time and live together and make provide for each other, and we're going to have our social trends and all that. All that good, happy stuff is going out the window because it's coming down to the wire of survival. Survival. That's got to be your common ground that you stand on. Start looking at it, people. Forming a community in an urban area without considering the weather changes and the various scenarios that can unfold that can endanger your community. You're not basing it on survival if you're not looking at those things, because those are the things that are at hand. And those are the things that we as a human race have to learn to cope with. God gave us one job, and that's to take care of this world, this creation, and we're not doing a very good job of it. So we ain't got nobody to blame for anything that's coming down except for ourselves, because we're the ones that screwed it up. We're screwing it up all the time, and it takes a mindset change. We have to decide we're going to do it differently, and we have to totally shift our lifestyle to survival and sustainability of the planet and ourselves. We can't follow up freaking greed no more. It's just not working. We can't let our egos guide us. It's not working. Now, none of us can truly let go of all those things, but we can, with conscious effort, learn to control them and deal with them. Those emotions, those things are there for a reason. God made them for a reason. We just don't know how to use them very good. So we should pull back from using them and evaluate and learn how to use them for survival. Because bottom line, it's about survival and not about our survival. God put us here to make sure everything else survives. He'll make sure we'll survive if we do our part. If we don't, we'll get spanked like we are right now. Mother Earth is going to spank our ass, and it's going to get worse. Smarten up, people. You want community? Base it on survival, lifestyle changes, and mindset change to sustaining this globe and all life upon it. Have a good day, people. That's my rant. Daho, signing off. Tim Walkenbear, Plant Whisperer out. Peace.